modern physics doesn't answer our most important questions. The main conflict between people concerns the question of whether so-called matter, as we know it now, is all that exists, or whether there is something more subtle besides it that affects matter, but can exist independently of it. The currently very popular among physicists string theory postulates the existence of additional seven dimensions that only appear in the microscale. Physics opens up to new worlds. In the case of string theory, this is probably a dead end, but it is a conceptual advance. So far, physics has rather blocked our imagination and was used by those who thought that science discovered most of what could be discovered to undermine the value of life. This intellectually primitive attitude has appeared many times in the history of mankind. Even if we assume that consciousness is a product of what we consider matter, it does not exclude that its creation may be an entry into this second, more subtle realm, and somehow makes our existence, or at least its most essential part, independent of so-called matter. It is even conceivable that the rise of consciousness can be initiated in this subtle realm. We do not know what part of the knowledge available to us is what we have already discovered. There is an infinite number of theories describing what we still don't know, which are consistent with what we have discovered so far. It's just a matter of imagination. There is also an infinite number of initial conditions and postulated unknown to us laws of physics that could be enforced in the period when density of matter was much greater than that what we could recreate so far in laboratories, which are consistent with all our knowledge about how universe later evolved. Big Bang, understood as the creation of everything from nothing, is one of an infinite number of possibilities. According to many physicists, it is logically contradictory, but very fashionable, mainly because of its simplicity. For today, we only know that around 13.8 billion years ago, this part of the universe that we observe had a volume close to zero, though the whole universe was then more likely infinite. Close and not equal to zero. What happened before, we do not know, because we do not know the laws of physics and the states of matter that it adopts at even higher densities. Our two main theories that we used to go back in time, general relativity and quantum theory, at higher densities of matter break down, and we need a theory that reconciles these two theories, the so-called quantum theory of relativity. For the same reason, we cannot explain the state of the matter inside the black holes. We have to distinguish between what is our knowledge and what is only a theory. We don't even know what it means to exist. We have to ask whether existence of universe is possible without a conscious observer. What would it mean to exist if nobody knows about it? We must be prepared that the answers to our most important questions may be beyond our imagination.